living down. No one gets away. Okay, well, you can tell I'm excited about our next books. Sorry. It's what happens when you get stuck inside for too long. Our next book is Whip the Mix, okay? And that song that I was jamming out to, that was popular when I was a little bit younger. So our lesson today is another H brother or digraph. Digraph, as you might want to say, WH. And what was the sound of WH? Do you remember that one? I bet you do. Wah. So just like if the W was by itself, okay? WH, wah. And if we're not sure, we can look at the whale. That helps us. Wah, whale. Okay? So I brought these things from my kitchen, and that's when I got the idea to play a fun song to get us excited about learning. So this is called a whisk, whisk. And you might see mom or dad, grandma, maybe using these to mix up some eggs. If you're having scrambled eggs, they might be whipping up some egg white to put a topping on a pie. This is a little one. There's actually two of them and they go in my mixer. So it can go way faster than if I'm doing it by hand. Okay. And our book is about whip the mix. Oh, all right. So here we go. You can get your book. This one, Whip the Mix, is number 93. So go ahead and find that in your packet. And I'm pretty excited about this, as you can tell. So on the back, our words to practice. The target skill is WH. It also told us that on the front. So let's go ahead and read those words. Do you want to read across or down? Across? Me too. Here we go. When, with, whips, which, whip, whisk. Well, who'd have thought? Whisk. They have in the book. My question is, why would they put whip and then whips? Why would the company that wrote this book put both of those words on the back? Well, because it could be very easy for you to read the word whip, and then you get kind of tricked up if you're hearing, or if you're seeing the S on the end. That might make you go, oh, I'm not sure what to say there. We just add the S sound, whips, okay? And then all our previously taught words that go under that, okay? So one thing that I have not talked about doing, and we usually do this when we're in school, and I haven't spent a lot of time doing that, but if you have a highlighter, you can use a crayon. You know what? You can just use a pen if you want to. It's just kind of fun to use some different colors sometimes. But what we usually do in school, do you remember, guys, is we take our highlighter and we say, what are we practicing reading today? Well, in this case, it's the digraph WH. And so we highlight that just to help our brains really recognize that quickly, and it doesn't stop us and make us think, what is that WH? Because we've already highlighted them. So we don't even read the first time, do we? We just find our WH words and highlight like crazy, don't we? Now I want you to notice on our sound spelling card here, WH and then the line. That means WH would only come at the beginning of a word. We're not going to find that at the back of a word, or the line would be in front here. So WH and then more letters. Okay. So here we go. I see this. Do you want to go ahead and get your highlighter? You can pause the video, go get a highlighter or a crayon. Okay. And then we don't even read, do we? We just get used to highlighting. So there's, I see a WH, WH, and a WH. Okay. Don't get confused. I see another graph down, digraph down here, TH. Okay. So it's good to recognize those H brothers, but we're looking for WH. So I had four on that page. How about you? You had four? Good. We're doing great. Okay. I'm going to go along again and just highlight as I move my marker across. And to me, I can notice those three words that I highlighted. They look like they're all the same to me, so we'll be able to read very fluently on that one, won't we? All right, I'm on page three. Go ahead and highlight. If you see some WH words, I sure do. All right, I'm double checking. Let's count how many we got on page three. Ready? One, two, three, four, five. Hey, and I notice, they look alike. That helps us be fluent, doesn't it? Okay, last page. Oh my gosh. Did you just get one on that page? All right, I think we're ready. Here we go. How about on the cover? You want to highlight the one on the cover? Okay. So another thing you could do to kind of just stretch your thinking. I know this is a whisk. We read the word whisk at the back, and I'm not going to look. I'm going to make my brain work hard. So whisk. I know I'm working with the WH on this one, so I'm going to write W. I. That's the short vowel I. Okay. Now slow down on this last part because it's a consonant blend. W. C or K? Well, we wouldn't end a word with a C. Okay, all right. So I'm going to put a K, whisk. Okay, so I wrote that next to my whisk there because that's another word that we can just add. All right, whip the mix. I like to track along with my finger when I'm reading. I think I do a better job. I don't get distracted. Which sentence am I on? I don't skip a word. Okay, it helps to that my eyes have something to track as I'm moving. All right, here we go. Read with me. Go. Whip the mix. All right, there's Dad with his whisk. Okay, ready? Go. Bob has a whisk. Bob can whip the mix with his whisk. On page two, read. Bob whips the mix. The mix puffs up. It's going to get bigger. It looks like fluff. Yum. Page three. Now we know Bob, and here's our new character's name. Read. Jill gets a whiff. Yum. When can we eat? Asks Jill. When? I'm hungry. Bob gets cups for them. Bob puts the fluff mix in two cups. The fluff is big in one cup. Which cup will Jill pick? Look at, that's not a fair share. But Bob did it. And then he said, Jill, you pick the one you want. Which one is Jill gonna pick? Do you think she likes more fluff Or do you think she likes just a little bit? Maybe because Bob is bigger, he should have more. I don't know. Maybe over here in some, with the extra space, you can write what you think is going to happen. So our story ended with a question. Which cup will Jill pick? Let's write a sentence over here. I can kind of see a line, so I'm going to write there. Jill, capital J, will, that rhymes, pick. Well, I can check my spelling right here, but I was pretty sure I knew how to spell that one, but it's good to check. Pick. The, do you think she'll pick the big one? You write what you think, and then we'll share answers. Can't wait to see, what did you guys pick? Jill will pick the, they put the small one. She's nice. She's gonna let Bob have the big cup of will. So, don't forget, we also have words on the back that you could be. There's my cup of whip. I picked the small cup. See why I got so excited for this book? Let's go to our next one. This is book 94. You can pause the video if you need a couple seconds to find your book. If you'd like a highlighter, I think this time I'm just going to circle the pen. Ready? Look for all your words on the cover. I have one, two, three. They all look the same. When. I'm just going to go ahead in my book and circle all the WH. On page one, I found 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that what you got? We're good. Keep going. Page two. I found 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You did two? WH. Remember, we want the H with it because that's what we're practicing. Don't get tripped up. Page three. 1, 2, 3, 4. Did you almost circle this one? I did. Saw that W. Not gonna fool. I can't believe this is another eating book. Food. Okay, did you find three on that last page? All right, here we go. I'm gonna use my whisk as a pointer. Ready? Read. When. I think she's ready for cake. Page one, read. When. What is that? Asked Pam. It is hot and good, said Dad. Trying to check out what time it was. Page two. Read. Pam got a whiff. Yum. When can we eat it? Pam ask. What is a whiff? It was when someone smells something. Take a whiff. Oh, my whipped topping. Take a whiff. When cake is baking, isn't it the best? Or when Patty cooks in the kitchen and she's making bread or muffins, or Mrs. Vanderheiden right around the corner from our room at school and her kids are all making a meal. Oh, I take a whiff and my tummy is just growling. Here we go, page 3. I gotta concentrate. I'm thinking about food. Ready? Page 3. We can eat it when Gramp gets here, said Dad. Oh, the cake is for Grandpa. When will Gramp get here? Asked Pam. I am here, yelled Gramp. When can we eat? Grandpa's excited to eat too. Do you think that's all that they are having for lunch when Grandpa comes over? Is cake? Holy smokes. That'd be my kind of deal. Okay. There's our two other books that we read just now for the WH digraph. Keep practicing. Oh,